You?
Hi, how are you?
Lou Gossett, Jr., of course.
See you.
And Clint Eastwood, Sandra Locke.
How are you? Nice to see you.
Sandra Locke.
Hello there. See you.
And Charles Bronson.
Charles Bronson.
Doing the best I can. Nobody's believing yet.
You look just like a fellow that works back here for me.
Well, that's me.
How are you, brother?
Well, you know what? I think they want some
pictures.
Group pictures. You got them?
You want all of us?
Come on, stand up.
Wait a minute.
Let's try to do a group picture.
Yes. All right. Yes, come in here.
That's great.
Yeah, we got the whole crew.
Great.
Do a couple more.
I think they want one just to, you'll forgive us, just all.
No, no, please.
The stag.
Is that a bit of mine?
Staff to take pride.
Rock Falls with this.
Everyone's looking here? Okay.
All right, let's move out.
Now we have just one shot with just the theater world here.
Come on, Charles.
We don't want Charles Bronson.
We don't want Charles Bronson. No, Charles.
Great, thank you.
Found out what I did for all this year.
Sometimes when you probably have to put on different than you feel.
Yes. Well, I think they want to see
everybody in the doors.
Because of where it is, about 90 degrees.
Nancy,
we follow you?
You. Jennifer, somebody will pick you up out here.
Take the Shelbyville girl out of the
bed. Yeah, Shelbyville girl. Knows all about those horses.
Good.
Ready?
Now, we better hold here just a second because we're a couple minutes ahead of schedule and I still see people coming in. So can you give me 30 seconds?
I'll get started not too soon.
Well, they'll be all right, I think. You might have
30 seconds.
This is pure Washington weather.
This is awful standing right here. It's going to be worse out.
How are you, sir?
Okay, they're ready.
Oh, wait a minute.
Well,
I left my brains on the desk.
Glad you remembered.
Yes, so much. Could be better speech if you winked.
Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States.
Picked up some creek bottom land. It's all covered with rocks and overgrown with brush, but he set to work and he hauled the rocks away and he cleaned the brush and he cultivated and he fertilized and he planted. Certainly been good to this place here. And he went on that way and the old boy was getting a little fidgety and finally he says, Reverend, I wish you could have seen it when the Lord was doing it by himself. Well, today we are honoring praiseworthy citizens who are giving God a hand in preserving our precious gifts. Unlike the farmer in the story, more often than not, those we honor today are protecting our land from some of mankind's more wasteful and destructive ways. Some of them have been set aside for the benefit and enjoyment of our people and for future generations. When one thinks of America, one thinks of life refuges, extraordinary urban park system and preserved historic sites, and all this is the legacy of caring individuals, perhaps like the ones we honor today, who acted to see that these treasures were preserved and passed on. Protecting our endangered species and to vigorously pursue plans to recover them. We've moved to stem the serious loss of vital wetlands. We've set a concerted effort we've made to mobilize the American people to get them involved in helping each other and in community building projects instead of just waiting for government. We call it our Private Sector Initiatives Program, Take Pride in America campaign. I thought it was terrific. If we really rely, or totally rely, on government, whether in conserving our public lands or in any other way seriously, yet I'm certain they will verify that there can be no greater boon to the conservation and preservation of America's national treasures than the active involvement of the American people. This is important to us. Our message to anyone who would trash or vandalize our public lands has been forcefully stated. That may be putting it mildly by some of the distinguished celebrities that were with us today. Those who would reduce the natural beauty. I know the Ad Council has given time to send the word over the airwaves and across the country, and they deserve a special thanks. So too do Secretaries Bennett, Odell, and Ling, who, they too have given us inspiring and energetic leadership. Today we've selected 38 recipients, and all those who contribute their time and effort are winners. And clearly, our country is the greatest winner of all. This is the first time this award ceremony or part of it has been held here at the White House. I think it underscores that's what the rest of us do. You. Thank you all. God bless you.
Mr. President, are our ships in danger of the Gulf? President, won't stop the war.
No questions.
Are you willing to talk to Gorbachev about the Persian Gulf, sir? Gorbachev says he wants to talk.
There are no questions. There are no answers.
Good morning, Mr. President. Good to see you.
Good to see you.
May I introduce the White House Science Council? This is Dr. Buxmaugher,
yes,
the chairman of AT&T. Yes. I'm a singer from MIT.
See you.
Dr. Teller.
Hey.
May I?
I have a little...
Thank you very much. Thank you.
This is Dr. David, the Nixon Science Advisor. Montgomery, Chief Scientist of IBM. Dr. Broadway from Yale. And Dr. David, the head of Scripps Institution of Oceanography.
That must be mine. I pulled that already. All right, look forward to reading it.
Look at the first book.
Better a soap page. Better a shield than a sword, if you can imagine less toxic.
Thank you very much. Well, listen, I'm grateful to all of you for taking the time to come in here. And as you know, this is an important and exciting subject. Certainly it is to me, because I've had difficulty with the pocket calculator. But from the news accounts I've read, the breakthroughs are being made every day that could affect almost anything that takes electricity. The government does basic research. The industry does commercial applications. And I think a strong and complementary relationship between industry and academia and government is vital to maintaining our nation's technology base and the relationship between our scientists and the private sector and the public sector. I recognize the important role that science plays in our economy, not just through immediate breakthroughs, but in our long-range needs in education, manufacturing, and basic research. And that is all the talk that I think I should indulge in, because I'm here to find out the answers to what seem to be some very exciting prospects.
Thank you, Mr. President. I might say just a word about the White House Science Council. It was formed at your behest in 1982 when Jay Heward was the President's Science Advisor, this job that I have now. They've been a very hard-working group and have done a large number of on the role of federal laboratories and research and reports on the overall educational basis and structure of our science and technology training. They meet every other month with me for the past 2 days. I find their advice invaluable and some of the good ideas that I pass along to you, I have to admit, come from these gentlemen before you.
Some are good and some are not so good.
Dr. Buxbaum, who is the chairman of the White House Science Council, is, I think, going to start the discussion and then introduce a few other members, but at any time, don't hesitate to interrupt or pursue your interests.
Mr. President, we appreciate the opportunity to meet with you. Very important topics. And I would like to give a few minutes to introduce.
Hi, how are you?
Hello, I'm the president.
Well, hello, President. Service is
from the city. Nice to see you.
Well, somebody else is going to have to give you the shots, man, Mr. President.
Yes, darn it. I know that I ought to be more charitable toward all the military down at Fort Benning, but I'm complaining.
Oh, okay. Well, 5 years, 5 years.
We wish you well.
Okay.
Smile, then.
Smile, I know.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I've run out of those white antihistamine pills.
I'll send them over. Okay.
Just two reminders for both of you.
Oh.
Just a little souvenir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.
And thank you. It's been an honor working with you.
Well, listen, thank you.
Thank you.
I'd like to thank you for all of the people in the military for my career and service and all of the things that you've done to help us.
We do.
I've seen the good times and the bad times and the best were with your administration.
Well, listen, on behalf of our country, thank you for all that you've done and the service that you've performed.
Thank you.
All
right. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I took the last pill this morning.
Thank you.
jobs that the princess, has not received.
Well, sir, you waiting for a hot shoe?
Hi, Bill.
How are you?
Just come. Others have just come from not the happiest of meetings at all at the National Health Institute. Seeing some children there with AIDS, small children. Oh, but they really are doing a remarkable job in the progress that they're making. Well, I'm pretty pleased to meet with the Drug Policy Board once again. There are many accomplishments that we can point to with pride. I'm particularly pleased with the total effort that each of you and each of your departments has put into fighting the drug problem. Ed Meese and others have kept me abreast of most of your progress, and I'm anxious to hear more today. If I can emphasize one point for you today, that is my charge to each of you to personally stay involved with this effort and to continue to make it a top priority for the remainder of our administration. I would like each cabinet member to arrange his or her schedule so that you would be able to attend every meeting of the National Drug Policy Board. This board offers a unique opportunity by which each department, in effect, sublimates their individual interests for that of the total federal drug effort through cooperation and coordination. For that reason, I hold each of you responsible to ensure that you work to eliminate the inevitable turf battles that detract from our goal of a drug-free America. And before I take too much time, let me turn this meeting over to your chairman, Ed Meese. I'm eager to get the latest dope. But forgive me for that. Take over.
Well, thank you, Mr. President. Mr. President, several things are taking place today at this meeting, which I think will show that we have made significant progress since our last report to you on the drug situation. One of the things is that we have now every cabinet department participating in the National Drug Policy Board, because we found that every department of government literally has something that they can contribute to this battle that you and the First Lady have really provided the leadership for. The second thing is, if